Hare Krishna Guruji, once again, sorry to ask so many questions. I don't know whether this is right, but I have an urge to ask. Sorry for that.
No problem. It's only to understand the entire Bhagavad Gita. That is our goal, Prabhu. So Bhagavad Gita has got answers for all the questions. So don't hesitate to ask questions. Hare Krishna, Prabhu.
Hare Krishna. So this was in connection with the previous discussion that we were having about the free will. So I just want to connect that with the free will of Brahma. When Brahma was created, I studied somewhere that Brahma was wanted to find the source of Brahma's origin, and he, while sitting on the lotus, and he went down the stick of the lotus for 1,000 years and then came back, and then he thought of dhyanam. So his free will for 1,000 years was to find out physically, and then he thought of doing the dhyanam and find out the things.
Yes.
What do you think?
That is correct. Because when Brahma was born, at that time he didn't know anything. He was completely clueless what to do. So that's why he was searching, like going through the stem. He went up to the Mahavishnu's navel, but still he couldn't find anything. And again he came back, and then he was meditating, and then he got the directions from Krishna that he needs to create. So that way, Brahma was not having any idea what to do. So that's what he did that. So yeah, he was using his free will to do like that. So everyone has got the free will. So of course, Brahma, his free will is to please Krishna. So that's what he was doing it at the end.
Dhanyavada, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhu, Hare Krishna. So like that, in this material world, for us also, without the knowledge, we are roaming here and there. We don't know what to do. We are not using our free will in the right direction. So once we get the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita, then we understand that our free will, we should use our free will, we should align our free will with Krishna's free will. Krishna also has got free will. So that's what we need to know. Krishna also desires, has desires. So we need to, our desires and Krishna's desires should be same. So that way we will be able to please Krishna. In this material world, when you want to please someone, you are acting up to his expectation. So that way you are trying to please that person. So similarly, here now we should act everything to please Krishna with the knowledge of Bhagavad Gita. So how we understand Krishna's desires? With the Bhagavad Gita knowledge, we fully understand Krishna's desires. What Krishna wants from us. Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Guruji. Hare Krishna.